Good evening. No, good morning or good afternoon. I don't know what time it is. I don't know what time you're watching this, but for me, it's Tuesday afternoon and it's about 3:30. Well, maybe 4:30. I'm not too sure. But anyway, good afternoon, good evening, good morning, or good midnight. I don't know if you can say that. Today, I'm going to quickly talk to you about calorie counting, calorie deficit, what your body does when you're just eating food, and yeah, let's get right into it. I'm not gonna spend a lot of time on this. Picking up from the last episode, we talked about, I talked about food, what to choose. I think I put your chat in the description box on YouTube. I've shown you what to eat and you can pick and choose fats, proteins, and carbohydrates with some fibers. And last episode, we talked about the glycemic index, and yeah, so today, calorie counting and calorie monitoring, and yeah, so what is a calorie? Right, a calorie is a measure of, you know, a calorie is what is needed by the body to produce heat. We are heat machines, apparently. I think we're warm-blooded, aren't we? So, you know, when you eat food, you wanna digest it, you wanna transport it, you wanna make sure that it's being made into that muscle. So, you know, our body needs energy constantly, so that heat that we produce from oxygen, which is another thing, I'm not gonna delve into that, maybe some other time, produce that energy. So when you eat carbohydrates, fats, or protein, they all take time to digest. So at the top, you got fat. Fats take, think they're easy to digest. Your body doesn't take a lot of effort to digest that. So let's say 400 calories, your body needs probably 5 calories, or it burns about 5 calories to digest that 100 calories of fat. However, carbohydrates, or should I say complex carbohydrates, they take a little bit longer because they need to be digested a bit more because of the glucose that is contained in those carbohydrates. So they take about, I think for every 100 calories of those carbohydrates, complex carbohydrates, sorry, you need about 10 calories, I think, that you need for your body to burn that food or digest or process that food. You got then your protein, which is your biggest of them all, it takes a long time to digest because it's just got 9 different amino acids in them. So amino acids, just different types of protein within protein. It can be broken down into 9 things. So yeah, that's why it takes longer. So you're looking at about for every 100 grams, or not 100 grams, for every 100 calories, or should I say for every 100 calories of protein, it will take or will burn at least 25 calories off those that are needed by the body to burn. So this is what you're going to be, this is what you need. So obviously that statement, when we say the things that we eat that makes you fuller for longer, all really we're saying is it's just taking your body some time to digest, to process that food. So obviously if you want to lose weight and you want to be more healthy and you want to be more efficient, you got to fix things that's going to help you burn more calories but at a much quicker, giving you better nutrition value. So obviously you got your protein, so that's why we say most of your plate should have a lot of protein, and then that's why we say you need more complex carbohydrates, because in the way in which it is digested, you use more energy to digest that food. So things like your fat or your empty calories, like you were saying, if you look at it, if they're just easy carbohydrates, your body is not taking much effort, so you're not burning anything, hence why it won't support you for your fat loss gains or losing weight type of thing. Moving on from that, if however you've chosen the right food, you eat them, you put them in nice good portions, and you're still not losing weight and you're not changing, and with the training, what you may then have to do, which really you won't really, if you do this the right way, what you may have to do is calorie count. I mean, a pound of fat is equivalent to 3,500 calories. So if I wanted to, let's say, lose a pound in a week on a regular basis, I have to get the approach of I need to at least burn that 500 calories, or had a 500 calorie deficit every day for me to lose that pound a week from whatever I'm already eating. So you having picked all that food, that chat that I gave you, I keep referencing to that, having food, you need to make sure you count your calories or eat less or 500 less than you already are at the minute. How do you do that? You then have to physically count those calories. Make sure that you have a scale, read the food labels, look at the things that you're putting in, and you know, you gotta monitor and be on top of it. It's simple as. So really, if you burn that 500 calories a day, have a 500 calorie deficit, by the end of the week, you'd have lost a pound of fat. So that is a really good tool to know. A pound of fat is equivalent to 3,500 calories already stored in your body, or whatever is in your body. So all you need to do is take 500 calories off that deficit from what you already eat on that day, every day for a week, you will then lose that pound of muscle. It works, and that's the law of thermo whatever calorie things it says in these books or when I'm reading it for. And yeah, that's it, calorie deficit. So, you know, you can play with the two, it works, but if you eat well, like I said, you won't need to calorie count, because I'm not gonna calorie count for the rest of my life. So why should I do it now? Why don't I do something that I already do every day and I wanna do when I'm 50, when I'm 60, when I'm 70, when I'm 80? I still wanna have a good ice cream when I'm 60. I don't wanna feel guilty about it. I still wanna have a good time on the weekend. So, you know, it's all about moderation and a balanced life. So yeah, that's the only things I wanted to talk to you about in calorie counting. Tomorrow we're gonna look at the ways in which we can use supplements. So supplements, like everybody knows, it's a new thing. Some people say they're steroids. Some people say they're hormone enhancers. Some people say they're not good for you and things like this. So we're gonna look at different things, the best ones and the ones I think are good, and what can aid you in your training, how to take them, and how you can use them to your advantage to get your fat loss gains. On that note, I'm gonna wrap this up. We're gonna go hit circuits, and yeah, we're gonna have some fun today. I don't know what to give them, but it's gonna be hard. I don't know, let's make it nice for them. Yeah, so that's the Star Pepper lesson for today. I hope you liked it. Please share, subscribe to anybody who wanna know about fat loss or who wanna know more about what Star Pepper's doing. Thank you for all your likes and your thumbs up. Send me some questions. I'll be ready to answer them for you as soon as I can. If you want to know more in-depth or direct answers, especially on this calorie deficit counting. If not, yeah, just enjoy it. If you don't like it, well, just find somebody who wants it. If you don't want to watch it, if you're good with your training and everything is spot on, please keep them the gains coming. And yeah, let's get it. Lightweight. Yeah, buddy, I'm out, man. Yep. Who's bad?